Hi guys, and welcome to part 4 of ASP.NET MVC core tutorials. On this part we are going to learn about the main working environments on .NET core, which are development and production environments. After you have opened the project that we have created on the last part, you need to go to the startup.cs file, which contains our iHost environment parameter on the public configure method. iHost environment is a service which provides the core abstraction for working with environments. ASP.NET Core introduces improved support for controlling application behavior across multiple environments, such as development, staging, and production. Environment variables are used to indicate which environment the application is running in. To check in which environment our application is running, we simply need to right-click on the project, then go to Properties, and on the third option here, Debug, we see that environment variable here is set to production. So we can say that our application is currently running on a production environment. But what does this mean? As we said in the beginning, the most important environments are development and production environments. The development environment should be used when we are actually developing an application, and production environment should be used when we publish the application. But how to find the environment that is being used on the runtime? So let us add another if check in here. To check whether the environment is development or production, then we add this to if conditions in here. The code in first if condition is going to be executed if the environment is development, and the second is going to be executed if the environment is production. Since we already checked from the properties of the project that our environment is production, we expect that the second condition is true, and we are going to see in our browser is production. To check this, let us first run the application. After we reach the breakpoint, we can go deeper to the environment properties, and here we have a property which says environment name is equal to production. So, is production is shown in our screen. Let us change the environment from production to development by right-clicking on the project, then properties, debug, and then here we write development. We save the file and we run the application again. When we reach the breakpoint, we check the environment properties and we will see that in this case, the property name here, environment name, will be development. So the first condition will be true and we are going to see in our screen is production. To easily locate the problems, we are going to use a method which comes with iApplicationBuilderService, and this method returns meaningful error messages to the developer. So for this we are going to write throw new exception, and here we write the message, this is a test exception. We make sure that we are on our development environment, then after we save and run the application. We can remove the breakpoint now. We see that the exception is thrown, so we continue by pressing F5. And now we see an error page with meaningful messages on our screen. On the top of the page, we are going to see our exception. This is a test exception, and this exception is a system exception type, thrown on startup.cs file inside the if environment is production block code. But when the users use our application, it doesn't make sense to display pages that do not make any sense to them. So when something is wrong, we simply redirect them to an error page which we are going to design later. So in the other condition, we would simply redirect them to a view. Thank you for watching and see you on the next part.